Hi friends, welcome back to my new lecture. Today we are going to learn about vacuum servo brake. The vacuum servo brake is generally used to reduce driver effort to apply the brake. First of all, let us see the construction and then we'll see the working. In the vacuum servo brake, there are four major components. The first major component is called as a control unit. So this part is called as control unit. Second part is the servo cylinder. This is servo cylinder. Third part, which is constructed in the vehicle tire or vehicle wheel, that's the third system, and the fourth system is the vacuum reservoir. So the vacuum servo is having these four components by using which we are going to learn how this stops the vehicle or reduce the amount of effort required by the driver. Let us see other component. This is the brake pedal. The brake pedal will be controlled by the driver's leg. When we have to apply the brake, he will give the force on this, and when we don't want to apply the brake, then it will be get released. So this brake pedal is connected to master cylinder. In the master cylinder, the fluid arrangement will be available there, and that fluid has came up to this one. So when the brake pedal is get pressed, then the fluid will get pressurized and the fluid level present here, that will be get rise. When brake pedal is released, then the fluid level which is present in this cylinder, it will be get reduced. Here this second component is control unit and another component is vacuum reservoir. Let us see what is vacuum reservoir. This vacuum reservoir has a three pipe connection. The first pipe, this particular pipe, is going for control unit. Then another pipe, this one is going for a servo cylinder, and then third pipe is going to the inlet of the manifold. So we know that the internal combustion engine has an inlet manifold. So here this pipeline will be going to the internal combustion engine. In the internal combustion engine, we have to supply air for burning of the fuel. So in the current arrangement, the air required for the internal combustion engine will be taken from a vacuum reservoir. So as air is used for the engine, here vacuum will be generated, and that vacuum will be supplied to the control unit as well as to the servo cylinder. So let's understand how this control unit is constructed. In the control unit, we are observing a three piston. This is the first piston, this is the first piston, this is second piston, and this is what, the third piston. So there are three piston togetherly connected with one single shaft or one single rod. This is one single rod, so this becomes one assembly. So when any one piston moves up, other two piston also has to move up, or when one piston moves down, other two piston also has to move down. So this is second cylinder and second piston and the third piston, they are operating two walls. Here is one wall and here is the another wall. Currently the piston, third piston, has closed this particular wall, whereas second piston has opened the wall. So the upper portion, this particular pipeline, is connected to atmosphere, means the atmosphere pressure will be acting in this particular zone. Because this wall is closed, on the downside there is no atmosphere pressure, whereas on the upper side we are having atmosphere pressure. Now what is on the downside? The downside portion is connected to reservoir, and as it is connected to reservoir, the vacuum will be present. Vacuum will be present in this zone. At the same time, as the wall is open, the vacuum is present here also. So the below third piston, there is all over vacuum, whereas above the piston we are having atmospheric pressure. On this control unit, we are having a two pipeline. One pipeline is coming from a reservoir, whereas another pipeline is coming from servo cylinder. Let us see what is there in servo cylinder. In the servo cylinder, there is a piston and rod arrangement. This is the piston and this is the rod. This rod is connected to the arrangement which is available in the wheel. So this piston is also has a spring mounted. So this is a spring. Spring always gives force towards left. Okay. And the piston will be moved forward and backward according to pressure available on the left side and right side. In the current situation, pressure available here is the vacuum pressure, because the reservoir pressure has came over here, and that same pressure will act on this left side part of the piston. Where on the right side part also there is vacuum, because on the right side part the pipeline is there and this pipeline is goes to the reservoir. So on the left side there is vacuum, on the right side there is vacuum. So same pressure is available on the piston. If piston pressure on the piston gets changed, then obviously piston will move towards left and right. But in the current situation, the piston pressure available on the left side and right side is same. So this rod of the piston is connected to the cam lever. So this is cam lever, and cam lever has arrangement of cam here. Let's understand what is the construction here. This particular part has named by the brake drum. So this is a brake drum. On the brake drum, a wheel will be mounted, which will be running with high speed. Inside a brake drum, we are having a brake shoe. This is a brake shoe, and this is another brake shoe. On the brake shoe, the brake lining, the black color you are observing, that is the brake lining there. Currently, there is a gap between a brake lining and brake drum. So brake drum will be rotating, and the brake lining is not connected to that, means brake is not applied. So as this piston rod moves left and right, the cam lever also moves left and right. And when cam lever moves left and right, the cam will rotate clockwise or anti-clockwise motion. So when it rotated anti-clockwise or clockwise motion, it will operate the brake. So we'll see later on how it operates the brake. But you have to understood that because of left and right movement of this particular rod, there will be application of brake, or brake will be get released. So this is overall construction of the vacuum servo brake. Now let's understand how it works. Current position shown is brake release position, means we have not applied the brake. So when brake is not applied, at that time this wall is open, this wall is closed. As I told you, the pressure above this one, there is atmospheric pressure, below is the vacuum, and the same vacuum pressure is applied on this side, left side of the piston and right side of the piston. As same pressure, the piston will not move, and as piston will not move, rod will not move, and as rod is not moving, cam lever also don't move, and cam will not rotate. As cam will not rotate, the brake shoe position will be maintained as shown in the figure, and hence brake drum will be rotating. There is no brake applied. So in the current position, the drum is rotating and vehicle has not stopped. Now let's understand what will happen when we apply brake. For application of brake, the driver has to give force on the brake pedal with this way. When the force is given on a brake pedal, the fluid which is present in the master cylinder, that will be pushed forward, and the fluid level in the control unit, it will increase. As the fluid level increases, this piston, the piston number 1, moves up. As piston number 1 moves up, piston number 2 and 3 also moves upward. When this piston moves up, this will close the wall which is present here. So this wall will be get closed. So here let's show the closed position, whereas this wall will be get open. So as this wall get open and this wall get closed, there will be difference in pressure above the piston number 2 and below the piston number 2. So as this wall get open, the atmospheric pressure which is present here, that will occupy in this zone. So here there will be atmospheric pressure, whereas this wall is closed, so atmospheric pressure cannot go down. So on the downside in this zone, there will be vacuum. So here what we are having is the vacuum, I will denote by V, whereas here pressure available is the atmospheric pressure. And that atmospheric pressure and vacuum, they will not come in contact with each other because this wall is closed by this piston. In the current situation, the atmospheric pressure which is present here, that will come here and that will occupy in this particular zone. So here on the left side of the piston, we are having atmospheric pressure, and on the right side of the piston, we are having the vacuum. So here is vacuum and here is the atmospheric pressure. So there is a difference in a pressure. As there is a difference in pressure, the piston will move from high pressure to low pressure. So high pressure is on the left side, the piston will move towards right. As piston moves towards right, this piston rod moves towards right and brake lever moves towards right. As brake lever moves towards right, this cam will rotate a clockwise direction like this. As this cam rotate a clockwise direction, this point on the cam that will come in a contact with this brake shoe, whereas this point on the cam, that will come in contact with this one. So let us see on the bigger picture. Here we can understand this point, when it rotate with clockwise, this point will come in contact with the brake shoe, whereas this point will come in contact with this one, and that will push this brake shoe on the left side and this shoe on the right side. When this brake shoe moves right and left, then the brake lining metal come in contact with the brake drum, and this brake lining will come in contact with the brake drum, and the rotation of brake drum will be stopped and brake will be applied. So under brake applied condition, the piston rod will move towards right side direction and brake is applied. In the current situation, a driver has to give a force only to open and close this valve, whereas the force required for operating this brake shoe will be taken from the difference in a pressure. So the force required to apply this piston is very less and the effort given by the driver will be very, very less. So driver will be in a comfort zone. Okay, and when we want to release the brake, so brake will be get released, and as brake get released, the fluid level which is present here, that will be get drop. As fluid level will get drop, the piston will also get drop, and hence the valve which was closed previously, this will open and this will get closed. As this will get closed, the atmosphere pressure will get break and it will not come down. So here there will be vacuum, and vacuum is present on this zone and this zone. As the same pressure is there, because of spring force, the rod will move towards left. Now as it rod moves left side, the cam also moves toward left side, and this cam will rotate in anti-clockwise direction, come to the initial position. When brake is applied, this elliptical cam may become horizontal, whereas when brake is released, it will become vertical one. So this is a simple working of servo brake, and this particular brake is very useful when we have to reduce the effort given by the driver. Thank you very much for listening.